If you're like me and you've been collecting video games in the wild for quite some time now, you may have noticed a trend just like I have. A lot of the video games that were out there and were easy to find, regardless of price, you would see them out there. But now, they're kind of non-existent. Let's talk about that. Before we get started, I think it's really important to define game collecting in the wild. I am sorry to break it to you guys. Antique malls and game stores and conventions, and I would even argue some places at the swap meet where vendors are specifically set up as video game booths, I have a hard time even saying those count. I'm talking about flea markets, swap meets, car boots, in the wild, people that don't sell games where you just randomly find stuff. That's how I define in the wild, and today I want to talk about those. These are console video games that simply are just impossible to find in the wild. These also can't be games that were never really seen in the wild to begin with. I can't simply say in this video, hey, how come I never see Neo Geo games or Jaguar games in the wild? Let's be honest, I never really did. So with that, we can officially get started now that I laid some ground rules. Gotta always lay those ground rules on YouTube. Trust me, comments go wild. One is GameCube games from the little cube that could. A great console released in 2001. I would say with the Nintendo GameCube, I didn't put nearly as much time into that console as I did really any other Nintendo consoles previous to that or even after. But as far as game hunting goes, especially in the wild, when Ricky and I would go out, even in our very first episode, we would find GameCube stuff all the time. Loose, complete, all the above, the consoles everywhere. And I really remember, even at that time, kind of skipping on a lot of these because, well, again, the point of this video, I'd see them everywhere. Yeah, I'd pick up the occasional kind of heavy hitters, and it's funny in the collecting world, there's always certain things that people kind of collect as a whole together. A lot of people go with trends on YouTube and desire certain things together. I know at the time we were collecting, it was things like Luigi's Mansion or Super Mario Sunshine, Star Fox stuff, and definitely anything also related to Pokemon. And I don't know how I forgot to say this, but definitely Zelda stuff. Especially that double disc one. People were always looking for that. That was the hot item.
We'd like that again with more Zelda for GameCube, but with the box, it just broke.
No, it didn't.
Box and manual, pretty good condition though.
Yeah, that is awesome.
And I remember as time went on, people would tell me, hey, the GameCube's gonna get hot. Little did we know, a lot of things were gonna get super hot in video gaming, but GameCube is gonna get hot. You gotta pick up more GameCube stuff. And I myself, as a collector, never really collected because things were getting hot or because I could potentially have more value in them later in life. I always just collected what I wanted to collect, and that's still pretty much the same way I do it. But needless to say, GameCube went way up. GameCube has gone bonkers. GameCube games, people are paying stupid prices for GameCube games. Whether you want to justify it or not, that's up to you. But for me, I rarely ever see GameCube stuff anymore in the wild. Remember what I told you was wild. You gotta make sure that you're taking the right consideration into what wild actually means. In the wild, wild. I don't see GameCube stuff. I rarely do.
Well, Rollin, it's all part of a $75 million marketing campaign designed to convince video game fans that GameCube is better than the competition.
The Sega Master System, probably one of my favorite looking consoles as far as just physical appeal of the console, a wonderful, beautiful little black machine released in 1986, at least in North America. And this console, I love it. I have so much back history with the Sega Master System. Just some of my favorite things about the console definitely is the music within the video games right there. I don't know what it is. I know that Nintendo technically has more catchy tunes, more superior tunes is from what people would probably say is the general consensus from people looking at the past of the 8-bit days. But for me, Sega Master System just holds so many wonderful nostalgic tunes. And with that said, going out game collecting, I wouldn't say I picked up a bunch of Sega Master System stuff back in the day, but I would definitely see the carts lying around and even a lot of stuff complete in box. I wouldn't say though this console or these games for this console were as abundant as any of the others on this list. Yeah, when it comes to, like I said, the GameCube, I would see tons. When it came to Sega Master System, I would see a good amount, but not as much as the Nintendo stuff. But needless to say, they were available loose and complete in the wild. But going forward, it's funny, I collected for it back then. Again, not crazy. But once I started going crazy for my SMS stuff, I started to collect it a ton and get really into it. I noticed I was kind of at the tail end of finding these games easy, and I was finding myself having to buy these games more at conventions or more at stores or at video game related swap meets, which I still don't consider in the wild because they're vendors specifically bringing that stuff. And it's become really hard. And now going forward, I would say of the ones on this list, Sega Master System is by far the ones I see the absolute least. I almost never see them in the actual wild anymore.
Shift into more excitement with the arcade hit Outrun, only on the Sega system. Sega.
The Nintendo Entertainment System. Now, I know you're gonna say you still see them out there, and that's true, but let me talk about it a little bit first to get to my point. The Nintendo Entertainment System is probably one of the most important consoles in gaming history. And let me add to that, I think the NES is the most important console when it comes to collecting and the collecting scene and game hunters and now flippers. I think the Nintendo is responsible for so much of this because in the early days of game collecting, NES was everything. Everybody was talking about the Nintendo Entertainment System. If you wanted to collect, if you wanted to be a game hunter, game collector, anything like that on YouTube, get back into gaming. It was the NES. We got to get back into the NES, the NES Pursuit on the Game Chasers. Always with the big hitters were the Flintstones games and the Samson games and all the Action 52s, the Angry Video Game Nerd. This in the NES is where I feel most of the hype in the retro video game world really stemmed from. I am losing my voice.
It's yours, dude. It's yours.
You serious?
It's yours.
Sure. Yeah. Dude, this is freaking rare.
I know.
And back then, game hunting, even when it was going wild in the beginning, there was tons of NES stuff everywhere. Of all these that I mentioned previously, this is the one that had the most abundance of video games everywhere. You could not run into NES games in the wild, no matter what. They were always out there. And what I was talking about earlier is, yeah, they still are out there and you can still find them. But as far as this video goes, talk about collecting in the wild. Yeah, you can lightly collect for the Nintendo in the wild these days, but you're not gonna really be able to get any bit of depth into your collection. I'm talking, you see the main hitters that you see everywhere. You see there's a list of like 20 games of all the, honestly, back then you could find at least the commons if you were having a tough game hunting time. But now you're just finding the extra common games that people don't even like. It's the bottom of the barrel stuff where you're just seeing the same faded games week in, week out, where no one even wants it for $2 anymore at this point.
Only from Nintendo. Now you're playing with power.
Those are my three top hardest to collect for video games nowadays that used to be easier to collect for. But with that said, let's make it easy. Let's leave on a high note. Here are some consoles or video games that are the easiest to collect for in the wild. I'm talking when we go to the swap meets and flea markets, it's almost impossible not to see these sitting on the edge of a table at every other booth. These are the consoles, might not be the best games, but you're gonna find these video games all the time in the wild. That would be the wonderful vintage looking Atari 2600 games. Next would be Xbox 360 games, which I know is gaining a good amount of momentum, but you still see them all the time lying around at the swap meets.
Oh my God, it was like magic. I found a couple of Xbox 360 games.
Ricky,
it was good luck!
Next would be the PlayStation 2, and I would say these are the ones that I see the most at places like thrift stores, which I know doesn't count in the wild, but I definitely, when I see stacks of DVDs, there's always PlayStation games mixed in there, and a lot of times, it's some good ones. I'm not a PlayStation 2 collector, and I'm not really a flipper at all, so I don't even really pick them up. Even if they're kind of worth something, I just leave them for whoever might want them next. And lastly would be the Sega Genesis. And as you know, I can speak to that now because I've been collecting them a lot. And I gotta say, you see them pretty often still in the wild, loose or even in the box, because yes, the Sega Genesis boxes, the cases, the clamshells, whatever you wanna call them, are darn durable. All right, let me know what you guys see the most out there, and what is the hardest? What is the hardest that has just broken your heart to where you're like, man, I used to see these all the time. And remember, that's the kicker. You had to have seen them all the time in the past, loose or full in the wild. You gotta remember in the wild. Yeah, I know so many people that taint that word and they go, I found it in the wild. And they're like, I went to an antique store where they're at a booth that sells video games. That's not in the wild to me. Wild to me is like Wild Wild West, where this guy sells nothing but baby toys and water bottles, and he had a Super Nintendo game back there. Why am I whispering? That's it. All right, thanks, guys. I appreciate it. Have a wonderful, beautiful, fantastic day. And remember, you're beautiful. No matter what they say, words can't bring you down.